Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us start the third unit of information security. So, in this section, we'll be discussing about the planning of security. So, basically, why we need these plans and all those things. Similarly, we will be also going through security technologies, guys. Okay? Yes. So, let us start. So, in this lecture, we will be going through the security policies and standards. So, basically, even most of us, even today, we'll be having the confusion between these policies and standards. So, what is the basic difference? So that thing we'll be discussing in this lecture with some examples also, guys. Okay? Yes. So let us start. So management of every organization must consider some policy as a basis of all information security efforts. So basically, whenever an organization is running, so they should have some policies to be followed by each and everyone to establish their security, their privacy and all those things, guys. Right? Yes. So let us continue. Okay, so security policies are the less expensive to execute the information security and is also the most complicated to attempt to implement, as a policy should be equal value to the whole organization. Okay, so before going through this point, let us first discuss about policy and standard, guys. So let us go through the definition first. Okay, so policy. So please concentrate now, guys. So policy. Policy is a set of guidelines or instructions of an organization managed to prepare and perform different activities. Okay, so policy is nothing but it is a rule or regulation which you should follow, right? Yes. Similarly, standard. So policies are the one which slowly converts into standards once everyone starts following them. Okay, so assume that, let us take an example, guys. So assume that in you are working in an organization, assume that it is a company. Okay, so previously there is no dress code, guys. You can wear any kind of dresses. There is no restriction of any kind of dresses, so you can wear any kind of dress. Okay? Yes. So initially, on the first day or in the second day, the CEO or someone, the higher authority, informed you that so from tomorrow there is no, only we allow only formal dresses. So assume that he gave in that way. So basically, in the initial stage, it will not be 100% strict, right? So they'll be giving a chance for few, like whoever are not willing to wear or not habituated for it, they'll be getting a chance like 1-2 days to adjust, right? Yes. So initial stages, it will be a policy, guys. Okay. So it is a guideline and instruction of an organization to be prepared and perform different activities. Okay. So after few weeks, like assume that after an year, okay. So 1 year has passed off. So a new employee comes. So for him, it is a guarantee rule, right? So he should wear, that's it. There's no other option for him. Right? So that is a standard. So basically, a policy will slowly, eventually, as per the time, it converts into a standard, guys. Okay? Yes. So basically, these policies can be given by a company for free, right? So you can give, you can just paste a poster saying that from tomorrow there is only this strict dress code, right? So that is, it's like saying to everyone or informing everyone is really easy, but making them follow or implement is one of the most toughest thing, guys. Okay? Yes. So now I hope everyone got some basic idea about policy and standard, right? So a small diagram for this is given, guys. So this is the diagram. Okay. Okay. So basically, policies and standards by senior managers. So basically, who will be giving these policies and standards, guys? Yes. So basically, these policies are told or informed. Okay. Or are sanctioned by the senior manager. So basically, they will be giving the policies. Okay, so policies are collected. Okay, and basically these policies drive into standards. So standards are built on sound policies and carry the weightage of the policy. So basically, sound policy is nothing but if everyone agrees, like that, the sound of the quality of the policy will determine whether it will be a standard or not. Okay, so basically these standards drive to practices, procedures and guidelines. So basically, these are standard, we should practice it, we should produce it, and we should follow the guidelines and everything. Yes? Yes. So that's all about it, guys. Okay? Yes. So practices, procedures, and guidelines include the detailed steps required to meet the requirement of standards. Okay? Yes. So I hope everyone got some basic idea about this standards and policies. So now let us go through the criteria of this security policies, guys. Okay? So policies are prepared to support the mission vision of the strategical plans. Okay, so criteria for security planning, security policy. So dissemination, that is nothing but distribution, guys. Guys, these all words are self-explanatory, guys. You can just observe them and you can just write in your own words. So in that way they are. Okay, so distribution. So basically, whenever a policy is ready, you should share it with everyone, right? So if you want to make it followed by everyone, you need to share it first of all to each and everyone. So that is nothing but distribution or dissemination. So whenever a new policy is added, it should be ready to share. Okay, so the sharing method could be any kind of format. It could be in terms of a paper, it could be in terms of images like PPTs, it could be in terms of photocopies or any kind of way, but you should share it. Okay, similarly, review, that is nothing but a reading. So basically, all the organization users should be able to read it and they should be able to give the review. So that is nothing but the reading or review, guys. So even the shared policy rule should be in multiple formats. So basically, in your organization, there could be someone who cannot read, right? Right. So for them, it should be in the audio format. For few, it should be in the text format. For few, it should be in the symbol format. Like that, we should have multiple formats of the same data, guys, because you need to inform this data to each and every member of your organization, right? Yes. So that is the reason why it should be happening. Okay. Similarly, comprehension, that is nothing but it should be understanding. So basically, you should not use some kind of crazy words in that rules and regulations, right? So it should be in simple ways, like everyone can understand. Even a small kid who can understand that particular language should be able to understand. So that is the goal of this comprehension. So it should be understandable, so every employee can understand and go through it. Okay, and there should be some quizzes and assessments, guys, because you cannot judge, right? So even if someone is teaching something, like even in our colleges, then everything that we are following is nothing but this process, guys. So our faculty will be teaching us and they'll be conducting some quizzes and exams to assess us, like this is your status, this is your marks, so you understood till this point, right? So that is nothing but this understanding. Okay, similarly, complaints, that is nothing but agreement. Okay, so for some practices, even agreements can be given. So basically, assume that there is a salary hike for every this month or this year, right? So in that situation, you need to take an agreement, right? So because the boss could just joke and he can say then it is a prank, like that, right? So there's a possibility, right? Yes. So in that way. Similarly, uniform enforcement. Okay, so basically, if for some employee you are giving, so assume that two employees are of the same level, guys. Okay, so their salary is same, everything is same, but for some one employee there is a providence of cap, but for you it is not there. So basically, it should always be in the uniform format. So that is also required, right? Yes. So I'm saying in terms of policies. Okay, yes. So I hope everyone got some basic idea about the concept of policies and standards. So in the next lecture, we'll be going through the concept of blueprints, guys. Okay, so let us meet in the next lecture. Thank you. Thanks for watching.